Would you like to have total control over your home budget for your household finances? Well, this video will show you how to use budgets in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. A budget in QuickBooks Online is simply a data sheet with the predicted or expected amounts of your accounts already input for each month, quarter, or year. You input the amount you predict or expect, and QuickBooks Online compares this to the actual transaction results. The budget reports in QuickBooks Online show you the results of the budget that you set up. They will tell you the difference between the expected or predicted amounts in the accounts from the actual amounts for specific time periods. They will tell you the percent difference between expected and actual transactions. It will be only from the income and expense type of accounts, because those are the only accounts that you can set up a home budget for. And it will be for specific time periods that you can divide by month, quarter, or year. Before creating a home budget, you should know that each individual created budget must be assigned to a specific fiscal year when you create it. You then decide the time intervals that you would like to budget. Your choices are monthly, quarterly, or annual, and again, based on the specific fiscal year assigned to that budget. For home finance, it's usually a monthly budget. It would still work the same way if we were making a budget for a business. We can make a budget for each fiscal year from last year to several years into the future. This means that we can even make a budget for transactions and dates that have already occurred. So let's make a 2021 forecast together. We will input the amounts that were predicted and compare this to the actual results and the actual transactions that we have already entered into your QuickBooks Online account for home finance. So we will make two budgets just to get the idea. The first one will be called optimistic and the next one will be called pessimistic. Let's see how to create one. You click the cog wheel in the top right and you go over to the tools column and click budgeting. Now, of course, if this is the first time that you're adding a budget to this account, you would get this window and you would click add budget. Now, it's only showing you a budget preview. First, you have to give it a name. Then you have to choose which fiscal year this budget will be for. And we will choose January to December of 2021. We will leave the intervals as monthly and we will not touch these other two. These other two are for contractors and other companies and businesses that those details would apply to, but they do not apply to us. So at the bottom right, click Next. Now, here's the budget that you're going to fill in before you save it. And you would put in the numbers before you click Save. And let's take a look at the numbers that we're going to put in. Okay. Here's the income section of the optimistic budget. Let's make February landscaping $4,000. So let's come here, landscaping income for February. You click the box. Tab to save it. Notice if you wanted, you could pre-fill all the rows by clicking the arrow, but we won't do that. So we'll click the X to clear the row and type it in again. Push tab on your keyboard to save only that box. Now we want to put bartending income for January, 2000. So we have bartending income for January, tab to save the box. What about April bartending income, 3,500? April bartending income. What else? Well, what about landscaping income for April, 10,000? Landscaping income for April, 10,000. Okay, let's see. Is there anything else in the income section? Nope. Let's take a look at the expense section for our optimistic budget. Okay, what about $100 in vet bills for January? So we scroll down, vet bills, January, click here, $100. What else? $125 for February vet bills. So vet bills, February, push tab. What else? Well, telephone expense for February, $300. Telephone expense, let's scroll to telephone expense. In the column of February, we click, push tab. $600 delivery expense for March. March, scroll down to delivery expense, or scroll up to delivery expense. For March, 600. Push tab. And $25 for March vet bills. So we scroll all the way down for vet bills in the column of March. What is it again? $25. Okay. Do not save the budget yet. Make sure we put everything. Yep. That's it for the optimistic budget. So, now that we put everything that we needed for the optimistic budget, by the way, the active row, you can just click away and another row becomes active. But if you click save, you have now saved the optimistic budget. Now let's take a look at the budget reports and see the difference between budget and actual. If we click the cog, okay, well, we don't click the cog. You would click the pull down arrow next to edit and click run budgets versus actual. Click here, and now you can see for the fiscal year, it isolates it month by month. This is what you really had. This is what the budget is. This is the amount over the budget, and this is the percent over the budget for January. Then, of course, you go across to February. This is what the actual landscaping income was. This is what the budgeted was. This is the amount over or under. And then this is the percent difference, and so on. And then every month has four rows: actual, budgeted, difference, and percent. If you go across to April, you can see that there was a lot of activity. There was a lot of actual, none budgeted, so the entire amount was over. But for April, for the income, here's the actual, and the optimistic was this in budget. So here's the difference, and here's the percent. And that's what it will tell you in the reports when you make a budget. Now let's do a pessimistic budget. So this will be the income section of the pessimistic budget after we create it. So we'll go again to cogwheel, budgeting, and once we get this list of budgets, we're going to click add budget. Now, this will be, spelling doesn't count because I don't care. Now, this will also be the same fiscal year, 2021. That's the point. You can have more than one budget for the same fiscal year and they will tell you the differences. Now, after you choose the fiscal year and the interval, as I said, these two do not apply to home finance. Click Next. And now let's put in the income section. $1,250 for bartending income for January. So January bartending income, $1,250. Let's see. $2,200 for February landscaping income. So February landscaping income, $2,200. Push tab to save the box. $2,800 bartending income for April. April bartending income, $2,800. What else? Well, $6,000 landscaping income for April. Landscaping income, April. Good. Now let's move to the expense section. Of the pessimistic budget, $250 for vet bills in January. We go January, scroll all the way down to vet bills, $250. Push tab. $2,000 in delivery expense for January. So delivery expense for January, $2,000. $525 telephone expense. So we go down to telephone expense for the month of February. $200 vet bills for the month of February. $950 delivery expense for March. $750 vet bills for March. So we're finished with putting in for this budget. So once we're finished putting in for the pessimistic budget, in the bottom right, click Save. Now you can see there are two budgets on our budget list, and both of them happen to be for the fiscal year of 2021. And to run the report, you click the pull down arrow and click Run Budgets versus Actual. And you can see for January, here are the differences in the income and the difference in the percent. And you can see the expenses for January. Here's the difference in the expense for delivery, the difference in the expense for vet bills, and it also tells you what percent of the budget that difference is. Then, of course, you would scroll over to February, and you would get the same four columns for February. Then, of course, you would scroll over to March, and you would see all the differences between actual and budgeted for March and the percent differences. And that's how you use the budget feature in QuickBooks Online.